assuming we're back on. I can't see a cue anywhere. Next up, let's head out to Florida to get to know more about Paige. Take a look at this. Good cheering, guys.
I am from Naples, Florida. I was born and raised in Naples, Florida, and lived there pretty much my entire life. My mom is an amazing person. She had to raise my brother and I by herself because we lost our dad at a very young age. My dad was paralyzed from the neck down when I was 2 years old, and he got sick, and when I was 4, he passed, so it's always really just been us three. My musical influence really come from my mom. She grew up singing in the church, so I grew up singing in the church as well.
The first time I really noticed that Paige had it, we were in church, and as she was singing the song, I kind of just got goosebumps all over.
It was a little bit part in a Christmas play, and I was so nervous, but after I did it, I wanted to do it again and again and again.
Everybody was like just blown away, you know, and after the show, they were just like coming up and saying, you know, she's really good. And then it's like people would actually come to church on the Sunday that Paige sang.
With Honkytonk Woman, here's the one and only Paige Miles.
And sold by a man from Memphis. He tried to take me upstairs for a ride. The man then covered me with roses.
Listen, when I heard you were doing this song, I thought, you know, this might not be a good look. It might be a little bit of a mess. But you know what? You did all right with it, man. You kind of pulled it out. I wish you'd had more energy with it and kind of rocked out hard. But you know what? I liked it. I liked it, man. E?
Yeah, I love that you use the stage. I think you have such great star quality. You have such great presence on stage. And I know you're struggling with your voice, so I was really worried for you. You sounded great. No one would know that you would have been struggling with your voice.
I didn't even know.
Yeah, she has been. And you really sounded amazing. Yeah.
Okay. For someone who was struggling, you really hit some big notes for someone who had those issues with your voice this week. So I have to applaud you for that, really. You attempted to do a lot with that song. At times, you may have gotten a little lost, but the Paige that we fell in love with, who's working the stage, who knows herself, the young Paige is back. That's what this performance is saying.
I didn't know what went wrong with your voice this week, Paige.
I have laryngitis.
You have laryngitis?
I didn't even know either. That's fine.
Oh, my God. Okay, well, taking that into account, you did great. I mean, you really hit some big notes. Song's a little bit generic, a little bit, you know, what you would hear in a bar. I still think you're better than that. You still yet haven't quite connected. Forget the laryngitis thing for a moment. You've still got to find something which makes you more unique, contemporary, very old-fashioned performance. But at least at moments, we heard the big voice which we loved when we really liked you in Hollywood.
Paige.
Hey, Ryan.
So, considering what you're going through, how much rehearsal could you actually have this week?
That was like my first full out, so I haven't really rehearsed.
That was the first time live during the show. All right.
Pretty much.
Well, if you're into the Honky Tonk Women, you can vote for Paige. 1-866-IDOLS-10. 1-866-436-5710. Or you can text the word vote to 5710. Thanks, Paige.